chair break. God damn it. I don't know what's going on with the chair. Dogs. Dogs are really bored. I hope somebody has sent me flowers. Wow. Again. Hi guys. Welcome back to another episode of MIMO, which is an acronym for me in my opinion. Also, you in your opinion. It's not just me. Again, one of the things I really love about this segment is that a segment. You think I have a show? Huh, a girl can dream. One of the things I really love about this series is that there's whenever I bring up a question or somebody sends me an email with a question that they need addressed, there's always, even if I give my support the best I can, but there's always valuable information in the comment section. With the last episode especially, the lady was dealing with her fiance that was dealing with masturbation addiction. There's two or three people who recommended this guy who helps men who are dealing with addiction and specifically masturbation. So that's something I did not even know that's something we can find in Kenya. So I'm very grateful for that. Guys, please continue to share this episode so that we can get as much help and build a nice, safe, warm, welcoming community around this MIMO segment, okay? I'm sorry my voice is a bit hoarse. Okay, to be honest, I've just not been sleeping well. I don't know why. There's a lot on my mind. I'm doing a lot right now, so I'm unable to sleep well. And whenever I don't sleep well, my voice is hoarse. And, you know, maybe that's when I should go into the studio and, like, drop an Adele-like track. You know what I mean? Hello. Here's today's question. Hey, girl. Hey. Hey. So much energy. First of all, I love you. You're literally a breath of fresh air. Thank you. I'm currently 24 years old and I'm dealing with a lot of guilt from my past fuck-ups, and it's been getting worse as we progress towards the end of the year. I've been struggling to forgive myself and move past whatever I'm dealing with. Sometimes even leaving bed is a struggle, and crying seems to be the only thing that's keeping me sane. I feel like I'm not good at anything. And it puts in parentheses or brackets. Is that the same thing? Well, I don't know. Talents and skills. Even whatever I pursued in university doesn't excite me anymore, even though I do know that it is what I am destined to do for sure, in caps. I'm a whole mess and time is moving. I need help in getting past the guilt and forgiving myself and getting started with life, cause I feel like I haven't. Any advice, please help. Lots of love. Thank you, sweetheart. First of all, your entire energy, I love your vibe. You've written to me this email with emojis and, you know, just cute. I can tell you're a nice girl. Everyone's a nice girl, but, you know, I can tell, like, you're a dope chick. So the main issue here obviously is guilt. She says, I'm dealing with a lot of guilt from my past fuck ups and it's been getting worse as we progress towards the end of the year. Don't we all have something that we wish we could just turn back the clock and wish we didn't do, that we feel guilty of doing? Something we did to somebody that hurt them, something we said to somebody, something we did to ourselves that affected us, that we feel guilty of, like, oh, I shouldn't have let myself sleep with this guy, you know, that kind of stuff. And guilt is one of those feelings that is so bad and can eat you up inside, because it's often laden with shame and feeling like you're worthless or you're a fuck up, you know. I have a few things in my life as well that I feel guilty of doing. I used to say I don't live in regret and I don't live in guilt. So whatever happens, happens. Da, da, da. That was my defense mechanism. But then deep down, I'd never really dealt with the feeling of guilt. So whenever the conversation about said event would come up, I would be so embarrassed and I'm still feeling so like, fuck, you know. But when you really start to address a certain event that you feel guilty for, even when it comes up in the present, it does not have the same triggering effect to you as it would have had if you had not dealt with it, or you had just suppressed it and put a band-aid on it. So the first thing I'd say to you, my darling, first understanding that what you did, and I'm sure you know this, but let me tell you why it's important to hear it from me. When you hear something from somebody else, sometimes it helps sort out your feelings better, okay? The thing is, what has happened. You cannot go back. But what you can do is start to practice acceptance of what happened and what you did. And you want to know why? Because at the time you did what you did, you knew what you knew. You did, even if you did something bad, at that time you're doing the best you can, because you're reacting with the experience, the knowledge, the emotional maturity that you have at that time to address that issue. So feeling guilty just shows you that this is an opportunity to learn, rather than this is something I need to feel bad about. So much so that it's even affecting how it feels like it's affecting your mental wellness. You see, you're saying you don't want to get out of bed, you're no longer excited about the course that you did in uni, yet you said for sure it's something that you're supposed to be doing. So this guilt is now starting to seep into other parts of your life, and you need to find a way to accept what happened in the past. I would advise you to go online and read about radical acceptance. It's a thing. Accepting what's happened in the past really helps with healing. Another thing I would advise is talking to a trusted friend about what happened, because talking to a loved one or talking to a friend about something you're feeling guilty of can help reduce the guilt and the feeling of shame that you have towards yourself. Because you're going to talk to somebody and, you know, you're able to deliberate with this person and they can give you pointers, and it's a relief knowing that, you know, when they say a problem shared is a problem half solved, I don't believe you need to share all your problems, but there are some of these things, if you have somebody you love and you know loves you back and you can talk to them about something, there's a relief you feel. And if you have that one person in your life that you can tell something, where the next day you're not feeling like, oh shit, I wish I didn't tell them that. Imagine, just talk to that person and allow them to allow the love and that connection through this conversation to heal you. If you don't have that person, or if you do that have that person, if the guilt is starting to really, really affect your mental wellness, I would advise also going for therapy to deal with the guilt. I've talked about therapy here a few times, so in this episode I'll also leave there was a whole thread on Twitter about that had different therapists available in Nairobi and their specialties and their focuses. So I'll leave it again in the description box of this video. Make sure you have a look. If not, you can look for a church counselor or that kind of thing. Just somebody who you can talk to through this with this problem, so they can help you manage it. But I have to say this. The thing about therapy is that therapists don't fix your problem. They don't go back into your life and fix your problem and make everything better. Neither do they fix your mistakes. They also do not change you. What therapy does is that it helps you work through these emotions that you're feeling towards this certain event, and it helps give you tools and better ways or healthier ways to create change, the change that you desire and the change that you truly deserve. I wish you told me a little bit about what happened so I could understand what it is you're feeling guilty of. When you're talking about the guilt you're feeling, all I can think of is maybe you're feeling guilty about some sort of relationship thing. Maybe you had sex with somebody you didn't want to have sex with. Maybe you said something to somebody when you were maybe intoxicated and you feel regret. Or maybe you stole something from a friend of yours, stole a job opportunity from somebody. Those are the only things I can think about. So I really wish you give me just a little bit more detail so that I'm able to give you a less generalized answer, and I can also pull out experiences from my life that I can tell you this, how I dealt with it. But in general, I really hope what I'm telling you can give you some. The thing is, everyone has things they are guilty of, or the things they feel guilty of. But when guilt starts to affect your daily life and your mental wellness, you have to reach out for help. Guilt is one of those feelings that can it can ruin your relationships. You know, let's say you've cheated on somebody and you don't want to leave them and you're feeling guilty. You know, there's people who the relationship ends because they're feeling so guilty, but they can't make amends with the issue. If you're not able to get past it and forgive yourself, you have to find other ways to deal with it, to address it. The final thing I would tell you to do, or the second last thing I tell you to do, is make amends with yourself. With yourself for what you did, or make amends with the person that you affected with your actions. Whether they accept it or not, I think it's good to just initially make that. Think about how you want to address that situation. If it's somebody who needs your forgiveness, plan a phone call, plan an email, plan a meeting, and think about how you're going to speak about what happened. Be genuine in how you ask for forgiveness, and understand that this person can either not want to forgive you or they forgive you. You know, put your ego completely aside. Like, just know they can blast you or whatever, but it's good to find a way to make amends, firstly with yourself, and forgive yourself and say, imagine I did what I did because I knew what I knew then, and it is what you have to forgive yourself. You're human. If God is forgiving you, you have to forgive yourself. Okay, so make amends with yourself and make amends with another party. And how you can make amends with yourself is not just saying I forgive myself. There are many tools out there, but something I know that really works for me is like mantras. So saying stuff to myself like, I am lovable, I am worthy of love, I am worthy of forgiveness, I'm worthy of acceptance, I love myself, finally I forgive myself. And something that helps, instead of saying I forgive myself, you can say something like, I am slowly making peace with what happened. That usually has less resistance than I forgive myself, because clearly you don't yet. But you can say something like, I'm slowly making peace with what happened. And always remember, things are always working out for you, even though they look like they're not. So whatever happened needed to happen for you to learn a certain lesson. Think about what you've learned from that and take that as the purpose of that experience. Your focus now moving forward should be renewal. I am renewing myself. What happened happened, and I'm gonna be fine. And even if the person doesn't forgive me yet, at least I'm making the steps towards a more positive change. That's what's important, not what happened. What's important is that you're doing the thing. You're doing the thing to be a better person, okay? So that's exactly, your tunnel vision and your focus should primarily be on that. All right, sweetie, that's all I have to say. Me, in my opinion, that's what I think you should do. Please don't feel guilty anymore. Those things that you're passionate about in life, continue to immerse yourself in them. And forgiving yourself is a form of self-care, so don't forget to do it on a daily basis. The mantras, the prayers, do that every day. If you guys have anything else to add to this conversation, please, please, please give this girl some advice in the comment section. Leave her a love heart, just so she can know that there's a community with her here that wants her to feel better so she can live better on my tiny little channel. And remember, it's your first time on this channel, give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Share with a friend who you think can benefit from this conversation, and subscribe. Okay, subscribe over here, over here, over here, over there. Hit the notification bell so that every time I upload a message, you get a ping and you can know new episode is up. Thank you so much for supporting me so far on MIMO, you guys. Like, the support has been amazing. If you have anything you want me to talk about on MIMO, just send me an email, something short, not more than 200 words. I know there's some of you who sent me longer ones, that's fine, but it's just that if they're too long, I won't be able to read everything and respond in good time. So send me your email to mytinylittlechannel@gmail.com. I have somebody who helps me go through the emails, and then we pick one every week or every other week. All right, thank you so much. I love you all, and see you guys on the next episode of MIMO. Toodles.
Into my life, a stranger.